In this tutorial, I'm going to show you some text animation techniques that you may not be aware of or that you may have been going the long way around to accomplish. These techniques quickly give your text animation a professional feel. We'll be using some text animators, creating shapes from text, and utilizing the 2023 Track Matte feature, which allows you to get the same results as Set Matte right at the layer level. As always, I'll be showing you a ton of tips, tricks, and shortcuts, so you don't want to miss this episode. Okay, so a command or control T to bring up your text tool. I'm just going to type the art of. I'm going to select that layer and hold down command and double click our pan around tool to center the anchor point. Go to our align panel and just align it to the center. It's command or control D to duplicate the art of and bring this underneath. And I'm just going to call this design. S for scale, and let's just scale this up so it's the same width as the art of. So now I'm going to roughly center this up for now, but I'm going to get it more precise here in just a bit. If we select our design layer and go to our character control panel, we can see that we have our fill color and our stroke color. And we have no stroke right now, as you can see with that red line going through that. Click this right here where it says no fill color. You want to make sure that the stroke color now is black. And then I'm going to increase my stroke width, which is this option right here that will say 3 pixels. Okay, so now let's just design these one at a time. We'll start with the art of. We open up that layer, go to this animate button, and we want to enable per character 3D. Then we want to add in a position text animator. And then within this animator right here, we want to add in opacity and also a blur. And the reason why I want to add everything into here is because we want to use this range selector, which is going to be animating our text. We want to use the range selector properties for all of these properties. For example, if opacity or blur were outside of this animator, we'd have to animate those using separate values. So let's go ahead and open up this range selector, and if your shape is set to square, your offset value, which is what animates the text animator, is 0 to 100. Now, if we change this to ramp up, the offset range is negative 100% to 100%. You can't really see anything right now because we haven't really adjusted these values down here. If we go down to our position text animator, and this is X, Y, and Z values, let's just change our Z value to negative, we'll say 2000. So see, our offset is set to 0%, so this is the midpoint. And you can see if you start to scrub through here. So negative 100% is where we're starting, 100% is where we end. I'm gonna put a keyframe for offset at the beginning of our animation, shift page down 1, 2, 3, 4 times, increase the offset to 100%. Randomize order defaults to off. But now if we turn that on, we can see that they're gonna come in randomly like that. The values that you're using for your position, opacity, and blur for your text animator is going to represent the beginning of your animation. What I mean by that is if we change our blur now to 100 and our opacity to 0, our beginning values are this negative 2000 on position, opacity 0, and blur 100. So now I want this to come more from a centered position. So you can see this outline of where our text begins. If we go to this position text animator again and just move this down, you can actually hit the quotation marks to bring up your guides and get a little bit more precise. So we want it to be about like that. Okay, and then one other thing I want to do is increase my ease low to 100%. Think of ease low as ease in and ease high as ease out. So watch that playback, and that's the look that we have. I have other tutorials that go over text animators. You can check those out. I'll have some links in the description. Okay, so that's going to be the animation for the art of. So now for design, I want to do something a little bit different. So if you right-click on this layer, create, and then create shapes from text. So now this is going to create a shape layer. So if you open up this shape layer, go into contents, you'll see that every letter gets its own group, and it's in order for you. If you open up those groups, you can see we have a stroke, and we have an option for fill, but it's been disabled. And that's because we did not have our fill enabled from the character control panel. Okay, so the way I want to animate this in is going to be using a trim paths. So let's close up this group here, select contents, go to our add button and add in a trim paths. Now you're going to make sure that your trim paths is underneath all of these other groups, so that way it affects all the groups. Open up trim paths, we're going to put a keyframe for end and change the percentage to 0. Shift page down 1, 2, 3 times and increase the end percentage to 100%. So if we watch that playback, we can see how this is going to draw our text on. So now there are a few options you have at this point. Trim paths defaults to trimming multiple shapes simultaneously. So as you can see, all of these shapes come in at the same time. You can change this to individually, and it will animate these in the order that you have your groups. whenever you create shapes from text, it's going to create the shape layers in order from left to right. If you wanted to do this individually, but you wanted a more randomized order, you can just shift these around. So make sure you don't accidentally drop these groups into each other, but just move these around a little bit and you can see just to get a different kind of look. Watch that playback and you can see how they can come on in a more randomized kind of way. So for this animation, I actually want mine to come on simultaneously like that. Okay, so I'm going to show you a few other little tricks. So let's close all of this up. Right-click in this area that's to the left of your timeline, new shape layer, and we'll just call this highlight. Okay, and then I'm going to pull the highlight layer, make sure it's underneath the art of. So open that up, go to our add button and add in a path. And I'm just going to make a path right on top of the word art. So click to make a vertex, hold down shift, and go to the end of the word art. So that way it makes your line straight. We want to add in a stroke. I'm going to change that stroke color to black. And then just increase the stroke width so it covers the word. If we hit T for opacity, we can lower this down and get a little bit better idea of how this is going to lay on top of the word. Using your arrow keys, I'm just going to arrow around so that way it covers the word about like that. I'm going to increase that back to 100%. Let's open up our stroke settings and maybe go a little bit thicker. So we'll say like 95. Actually, we don't want it to touch our design text down there. So maybe we'll make this about 90. Okay, so now let's animate this on. So go to the add button, add in a trim paths, put a keyframe for end and change it to 0. Shift page down 1, 2, 3 times, increase that to 100%. Now if you click the word end, it will highlight all of the keyframes. And just F9 to make those easy ease. We're going to open up our graph editor and then just grab these handles. You want to bring the left one as far right as you can and the right one as far left as you can. Fit this back to our comp. Hit U to bring up your keyframes on all of these layers here. So first we have the art of design coming in, and then we want our highlight to come in once everything is animated in. So we'll have this. Okay, so now I want the word art to be white, and I want it to be on top of this highlight. And actually, let me see, it's still a little bit thick. If you select the highlight layer, go to your finder, type in stroke. We can see that our stroke property will pop up here. And let's just kind of get that a little bit tighter, maybe something like that. I just don't want the highlight to touch the word design. Okay, so the way I'm going to do this is if you take this art of layer, Control-D to duplicate it, go up to our control panel, and then let's change this color to white. So see now, the art of is white, but I only want it to show up inside of this highlight. So I'm just going to change this second text layer to overlay. So what we're going to do now is take this layer. This is our track matte feature that's new for After Effects 2023. You can actually use this as a set matte. Just take this pick whip and select highlight. And now notice by default, it's going to turn that layer off. So just turn that back on. So see now art sits on top of that highlight. However, we don't want the black text of art to be showing. Solo that layer and let's turn on transparency. You can see that the art of is still showing up. So the way to get rid of that, we can take our original text, the art of, and pick whip our track matte to the highlight. Only art shows up. However, we want only the and of to show up. The way you do that is to invert that track matte. Okay, so just unsolo that so that way everything comes back in and kind of scrub through and see how this is going to work. So we're going to get that highlight on the word art. Let's fit our view back to the comp size. If you right click in this area to the left of your timeline, new shape layer. And let's add in a rectangle, and then we're going to add in a stroke. And I also want to put this inside of a group. Okay, so let's bring our rectangle and our stroke inside of that group. Open up our stroke settings. Let's change this color to black. We can unconstrain our rectangle path size settings and just draw a box around our text. So now at this point, you can see that our text isn't perfectly centered. So Shift Command Option Y to create a new null object. I'm going to rename that to text control. You can just grab all of these layers that make up our text animation, pick whip that up to the text control, P for position, just move that up. Okay, so we're going to call this accent. Let's open that back up and make some changes. So let's increase our stroke width a little bit. We'll say 30 pixels. Let's add in a trim pass within that group. Open that up and let's change our end percentage, we'll say to 5. And then just take your offset here and move it around so it kind of forms a corner like that. Select accent, hit your left bracket, and it will bring the beginning of that layer over. Let's put a keyframe for end and then just move that down a little bit. Make the opening percentage 0. And actually, I want to make this an exact amount. So we're going to say shift page down 1, 2, 3 times. Bring this last keyframe over. We're going to highlight those. F9, make those easy ease. And like our highlight layer, we want to take this left handle, put all the way to the right. Right handle, pull all the way to the left. So what we get is something that looks like that. So it kind of starts off slow, goes fast, and ends slow. So now I want one of these little corners on both sides. Take this group, duplicate that. We can open up group 2 and then open up trim paths. And our offset is set to -9. So I want to go to the exact opposite side. And that's going to be 180 degrees. So just go to the end of -9 plus 180. And it pops up right there on the exact opposite side of this rectangle path. And I just want to offset this a little bit so that way they come in a little bit offset like that. So these are just a few text animation techniques that you can add to your projects to give it more of a professional feel. Hope this helped you guys out, and I'll see you next time. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.